Who built the Great Pyramids? Who carved Kailash Temple? Who quarried, carved, and transported the Moai statues around the coastline of Easter Island? The reason for our persistence in reiterating these questions is that it unlocks one's perception to the reality of unknowns. They suddenly notice that there are some things about the past in which they had been taught were a lie. The ancient marvels of India, as but one example, how can those who are placed in a position of trust, responsibility, and above all, critical thought, explain these stoneworks away as ones coming from the hands of untrained slaves? Yet even when these ruins are presented as that of the work of ancient masters, the tools and metal technologies available to any of them were simply incapable of accomplishing these refined, masterfully finished feats, sometimes leaving walls of granite so precisely executed they became reflective. The more one studies these stoneworked anomalies, still abundant amongst the many as yet unexplained sites all over the world, you soon begin to see scars and marks left upon these stones, reminiscent of modern-day electric power tools, and some indicative of stone-cutting technology, which evades even our own modern capabilities, like that of the star holes we have covered in the past. These mysterious artifacts suggest the civilization responsible was not only advanced, but possibly once more advanced than modern man. Panoia's Sanctuary. According to academia, once ordered to be built by the Roman senator Caius Calpurnius Rufinus, they claimed the sanctuary was dedicated to infernal deities, headed by Serapis and the deities of Iapetus. However, due to the astonishing precision of some of the stone cuts made into these large granite boulders, we posit that the Romans were merely re-inhabitors of this, along with many other ancient structures, to which mystery history attests the creation of were far out of the capabilities of the Roman Empire itself. Furthermore, that the Romans rapidly recorded technological and agricultural developments, just like that of the Inca, Mayan, Egyptian, etc., was largely the result of deciphering, reverse engineering, and the eventual adoption of technological relics left by a far more capable, once world-going, yet now lost civilization. At the site, there are many impressive ancient stone carving achievements. Perfectly square boreholes, largely perfect cylindrical drill holes, left in the hard granite many thousands of years ago. The volume and abundance of lichen species, and the sizes these colonies have become, also confirming the great age and authenticity of the boreholes and the site itself. Ultimately, if one wishes to conclude that this ancient sanctuary was indeed the work of the claimed builder, proof must be provided that said individuals were capable of such incredible work, not only capable of the task, but the cut upon stones engulfed with millennia-old colonies of lichen without seemingly damaging them. For many colonies now draped across the stoneworks, we attest are far older than the Roman Empire itself, with many flowers already a considerable size before they watched the Romans arrive, thrive, and eventually disappear. Yet alas, without biological proof of the age of some of these species, and the fact that any funded institution would dismiss any of the dates we would pursue as anomalies, it appears the jury remains out on the site, and the debate rages on. It is a place which we find highly compelling.